chatting anyway. So hello, my name's Mark Simmonds, and my purpose in this little bit here is just to give you a brief introduction to Transition Enterprise, what it is, and also going to give a little bit of a plug for my workshops later on to see, so you can basically make the decision that's the sort of thing I want to go to. So I'm a fairly recent addition to the REconomy team, and my official title is Enterprise Advisor, and I'm sort of filling a little bit of a gap in that we have got enterprises coming out of transition or inspired transition at the moment, and I'm there to basically signpost, give a little bit of support, because I'm really, really lucky as I actually managed to make my living going around the country helping people set up enterprises, cooperatives, social enterprises, and particularly work with a lot of enterprises coming out of transition as well. So another plug for this booklet that you can download, the coming out of the REconomy project, The New Economy in 20 Enterprises. I'm actually really privileged to have actually worked with quite a few of those over the years. So, yeah. What I'm going to do is define a transition enterprise or a transition-oriented enterprise. We're in a little bit of a sort of like indecision at the moment about what we're going to call these things in order that we can appeal to people outside of transition as well as inside transition. So apologies if I slip between terminology at the moment. But it's basically a financially viable trading entity that fulfills a real community need, delivers social benefits, and has beneficial or at least neutral environmental impacts. Okay. And we came up early on with five principles around that. So a transition enterprise should be working towards, it's a fairly inclusive set of principles as well. So people who are working towards this stuff, you know, are people who should be on the journey with us. So strengthen local resilience, use resources appropriately. Okay, so we're not specifying zero carbon at that point because it's going to be very hard for any enterprise to be zero carbon at the moment, but we're working towards that certainly. Operate at the appropriate scale. So is it appropriate for it to be local? Is it appropriate to go out within its bioregion? Is it appropriate for a transit enterprise to actually have a national reach? Does that actually make sense? So they're about more than profit. So they're about not-for-profit. It's more about what they do with the profit that's important. And ideally, a part of the community. So whether that's a geographic community or a community of interest. So again, fairly loose principles at the moment. Still, you know, we're in the early stages of this stuff. Stuff is still beginning to crystallise around this. And events like this enable us to, you know, put some more flesh on these bones as well. So I've already flagged up the report that you can download from the REconomy website. And I'm just going to show you three examples of transition enterprises, so enterprises that fit that definition, two of which are actually mentioned in this report. So I've pulled the two Scottish ones out and I've chucked another Scottish one in as well. So this is Uig Community Shop. Have I said it right? Uig. Uig. I've been to Uig in Skye. This is Uig in Lewis. Okay, so this is basically a classic community coming together to run their own retail business within that community. So I've worked with quite a few of these over the years in the UK. They're particularly supported by an organisation called the Plunkett Foundation. So there's nearly, I think there's over 300 different community-owned shops in the UK now, a couple of which are in Scotland. They're a fairly well-understood, sort of tried and tested model. Things like this, you can almost take them off the shelf. Plunkett Foundation are also working with cooperative pubs. So for example, I'm wearing my local pub, the Fox and Goose cooperative pub. We were supported by the Plunkett Foundation. And I think when we opened, we were the 25th cooperative pub. So pubs are coming up on the outside with community-owned shops. And again, it's a big growth area. But it's a classic example of how community enterprise and transition enterprise tends to get going. They tend to be inspired by another example that's geographically distant. which is why I think the REconomy project is particularly important, because it's taking a more strategic view of looking at how can we actually design from the community's point of view, rather than what tends to be happening at the moment is, that's brilliant, we could do it here, and almost like creating your own version of it, but parachuting it in. So taking a more strategic, looking at those economic enablers, looking at actually planning how all these new enterprises that might be starting within a community can actually work together in a more supportive way, rather than just relying on that to happen organically. So, Uyghur Community Shop, classic example. Another one coming out of Sustaining Dunbar. So Sustaining Dunbar have been a particularly active transition initiative in terms of the number of enterprises that have come out of that. So, a classic car club, really. Again, we can show examples of them all over the country. Basically just a way of people to share the ownership and responsibility of running a car. I'm not going to say huge amounts more about the Dunbar. I've got another Dunbar example. If you want to know more about them, I'll just talk to Philip, who you're up next, aren't you, Philip? Okay, so I don't want to steal any thunder. And this is another Dunbar example. I've worked with quite a lot of community bakers. Again, it's a classic example. So one of the first transition enterprises that we saw was the Handmade Bakery in Slowart, down near Huddersfield. Emerged out of Marsden and Slough transition town, people involved with it basically decided that they were particularly passionate about artisan bread, but they also wanted to create a sustainable enterprise for themselves. So they set up the Handmade Bakery. Then we saw an explosion of artisan bakeries, particularly community-owned bakers around the country. Dunbar Bakery, Community Bakery being one of them. And particularly interesting because it's one of the family of new enterprises that we're seeing where they've actually gone to their communities and said, here's an amazing business idea, this is the money we need to do it, you can give us that money. You can invest in this enterprise in a way that then you own and control it. So we're seeing a massive upsurge over the last few years in community-owned enterprises where the community have actually funded it. They've bought shares in it. So Fox and Goose pub, we raise £130,000 to buy our local pub. Dunbar Community Bakery, what was there? How much did they raise?
About 6,000 or 7,000.
Okay. And have also had funding from other sources as well, because that's the other nice thing about community investment. Once you've got that money in from the community, it gives you leverage to pull money in from other sources as well. And the really big area of growth in here is around community energy. And that's where I think it gets quite exciting. When we're looking at economies rather than enterprises, where part of that economy is community energy companies that are owned and run by the community, those are the community enterprises that are really quite profitable at the moment. So if we can actually be using that profit to stimulate the rest of the economy as well, that's a real sort of trick that's being missed at the moment. That we are seeing some examples of it. Just a little plug for Community Shares Scotland as well. There is a project being run in Scotland specifically to support community enterprises that are going to use community investment to start themselves. So Community Shares Scotland, if you just Google it, you'll pull up their website. So how REconomy can help transition enterprises, okay? The main thrust of the work around this is supporting the transition initiatives to become those engines to create those transition enterprises within them as well. To do that, we're developing some resources. So I'm putting together a how to start a transition enterprise guide at the moment, which we're desperate for a better name for. So if you can think of a better name for how to start a transition oriented enterprise, which is what its working title is at the moment, then please come and tell me. So part of this is around sharing success as well. So I'm particularly keen to find out what's going on in Scotland at the moment, because I don't know a huge amount about it apart from the stuff I'm hearing coming out of Dunbar. So events like this are really important because these transition enterprises, they're like the sort of the new things in the gene pool. We're at that very early primordial soup time where there's the bits of life that are just starting. And events like this is like stirring that primordial soup. So we get people take a bit of one thing and stick it on another and say, oh, they did that and we'll put that in there. And new things come up and some of them survive and some of them die. So particularly about sharing success and also sharing failure, I should say, as well. I've got some limited capacity to do one-to-one support, so if you're starting an enterprise at the moment, come and get my card off me and I'm happy to talk to you over the phone and chat to you by email, and also signpost, because there's people like me in Scotland, because I'm based in West Yorkshire, so I'm a good 5 hours away, but there's people who do my job and scrape a living as transition entrepreneurs, or for want of a better term, and they are much more local to you in Scotland.